48 to 50 of the chapter Indigo. So it is part 4th of the chapter Indigo. Okay. So we all know very well that in this chapter, what is the basic theme? The theme is effective leadership. Effective leadership. Effective leadership of Mahatma Gandhi. So we have come to know that effective leadership can solve any problem. Effective leadership can solve any problem, and it is taught in this chapter as Mahatma Gandhi's effective leadership worked in the Champaran, and with that effective leadership Mahatma Gandhi solved the problem of Indigo sharecroppers. Okay, so we have started the chapter how Indigo is an extract taken out from the life of Mahatma Gandhi. The life of Mahatma Gandhi, fine. And we all know very well that the life of Mahatma Gandhi is written by Louis Pasteur. Okay, is written by Louis Pasteur. So this Indigo is an extract taken out from the life of Mahatma Gandhi, one of the best book ever written on Gandhi. One of the best books ever written on Gandhi. Okay, the life of Mahatma Gandhi. And Indigo is an extract taken out from that book by Louis Pasteur. Louis Pasteur was follower of Mahatma Gandhi, and Louis Pasteur respected and loved what? Mahatma Gandhi's principle of non-violence. Means Mahatma Gandhi used non-violence as a tool in politics. So we have started the chapter like this way, that this chapter Indigo is an extract taken out from the life of Mahatma Gandhi, and this is an interview. We are reading an interview. Why? Because Louis Pasteur went to take interview of Mahatma Gandhi in Sevagram ashram, and he had taken the interview in the year 1942. Interview was taken in the year 1942. So in 1942, Mahatma Gandhi announced, Mahatma Gandhi means revealed one fact. Mahatma Gandhi revealed one fact. Why did he urge Britishers to leave India? Means Britishers ko kyun karna leave India? So it was happened in the year 1917. Why? Now the chapter started like this way, that in the year 1916, when Mahatma Gandhi was attending and addressing annual convention, okay, of Indian National Congress in Lucknow, over there a peasant, illiterate, emaciated, very thin, very weak peasant, Rajkumar Shukla, approached Mahatma Gandhi, and he requested Mahatma Gandhi to come to Champaran. Mahatma Gandhi refused. Why? Because he had some urgent work. He had some urgent work in Kamapur, and then he had fixed meeting in different parts of India. So he refused. Okay. And first of all, the basic reason was Mahatma Gandhi did not know where Champaran was. So Mahatma Gandhi refused. But then Rajkumar Shukla was determined, was resolute person. Okay. And he followed Mahatma Gandhi everywhere, and he begged, fix a date. Okay, so he begged for what? Fix a date. And finally, Mahatma Gandhi was highly impressed with the tenacity, with the determination of Rajkumar Shukla, and he agreed, and he had conveyed what? Rajkumar Shukla could take Mahatma Gandhi from Calcutta on that day. Okay, and on the fixed day in Calcutta, Rajkumar Shukla met Mahatma Gandhi, and both of them boarded the train for Bihar. Okay, but Rajkumar Shukla did not take Mahatma Gandhi from Bihar to Champaran. He wanted Mahatma Gandhi to stay for some time in Patna. Why? He escorted Mahatma Gandhi to Rajendra Prasad house. Whose house? Rajendra Prasad's house. Rajendra Prasad, we all know very well that he was former first president of India, and he was also during the case of
Pizanj. So there was a doubt in Rajkumar Shukla's mind. What he thought that he was unable to impart the information to Gandhi. That's why he wanted Rajendra Prasad to impart to convey everything what he was unable to convey to Mahatma Gandhi. So in that means thought he escorted Mahatma Gandhi to Rajendra Prasad house. But Rajendra Prasad was not at home, and the servants over there behaved very badly with Mahatma Gandhi, because at that time in India untouchability caste system was prevailing. Okay, and it was prevailing on full swing, bahut hi high swing pe chal raha tha untouchability. So Mahatma Gandhi was what sad, and when he came to know that untouchability was also prevailing in India, so he decided not to move ahead Champaran. First he wanted to go to Muzaffarpur, which en route to Champaran, on the way to Champaran, and he sent the telegram to J.B. Kriplani. J.B. Kriplani was professor in the Arts College, and he had sent the telegram to J.B. Kriplani. And then J.B. Kriplani, whom he had met in Tagore Shanti Niketan. Okay, so J.B. Kriplani welcomed Mahatma Gandhi at midnight on 15 April 1917. So J.B. Kriplani welcomed Mahatma Gandhi with a huge number of the students, okay, bodies of the students. And then Mahatma Gandhi stayed at Malkani's house. So Mahatma Gandhi told it was an extraordinary thing at that time. Please note this line. It was an extraordinary thing at that time. Means what was the extraordinary thing? To give a shelter to any person, to give a shelter to an advocate by a government official. Why? Because Malkani was a school government teacher, and government officials were not allowed to give shelter to any advocate. Means it was against the system, but Malkani had given shelter to Mahatma Gandhi. So that's why Mahatma Gandhi quoted that it was an extraordinary thing. Then Mahatma Gandhi stayed there, and at Malkani's house, when news of Gandhi's arrival reached everywhere, Mahatma Gandhi was at that time in Muzaffarpur. So when news of the arrival of Mahatma Gandhi reached Muzaffarpur, throughout Muzaffarpur, Champaran, so peasants approached Mahatma Gandhi. Someone came on foot, someone came by cart or whatever the conveyance they had, they approached Mahatma Gandhi, because everybody was excited. Why? Because they thought that their champion had arrived in Muzaffarpur. So Mahatma Gandhi called all the lawyers over there, and he asked them about the case and fee. Then lawyers informed about the cases and about the fee. Then Mahatma Gandhi chided the lawyers. Why? Because for collecting big fee from the sharecroppers. He said, I have come to the conclusion that we should stop going to law courts. He said, please stop going to law courts. Why? Because it would not bring any beneficial. Why? Because farmers, peasants were already crushed with the sharecropping system, and moreover lawyers were taking the high fee, and there was no result of taking the cases in the law courts. As who was in power? Britishers were in power. So stop going to law courts, and real relief for them is to free from fear. Okay, so we have completed up to here. Then most of the arable land in Champaran district was divided into large estates owned by Englishmen and worked by Indian tenants. Tenants means kiraidar. The chief commercial crop was indigo. The landlords compelled all tenants to plant 3/20 or 15% of their holdings with indigo and surrender the entire indigo harvesters. Then it is a problem. What? That Indian sharecroppers, Indian farmers were working on the land. They were cultivating wheat, maize, whatever. But along with that crop, they had to grow indigo in Champaran, and the whole indigo was surrendered to Britishers, landlords, mostly Britishers. Okay, some Indian landlords were also there, but most of the landlords were Britishers. So whole indigo was surrendered to the British landlords, and then landlords sold that indigo in Germany and were earning money. Getting my point? So chief commercial crop was indigo in Bihar, and moreover, if you grow indigo on a land, the land got barren with the effect of indigo. So it is the problem that they had to grow indigo along with their crop, and the whole indigo from that they can earn money. They could not. वो नहीं पैसा कमा सकते farmers. क्यों? क्योंकि the whole indigo was surrendered as a rent to the landlord. It was the main problem. Then one more problem was aroused with that thing. Getting my point? So presently the landlords learned that Germany had developed synthetic indigo. So landlords were selling that indigo in Germany, okay, and were earning money. But now what happened? The main problem, where did main problem arise? कहाँ main problem होता है? With Germany, which country was taking indigo from the Britishers of India. Germany had developed synthetic indigo. Which indigo? Germany had developed synthetic indigo. Okay. And they did not want indigo from the landlords. Getting my point? So Germany had developed synthetic indigo. So that's why they did not need indigo from the Britishers or from landlords. Okay. From India. So they stopped the supply. They did not want to buy. So here the main problem had aroused. Why? Because now landlords did not want indigo from the sharecroppers. Because what they would do that with that indigo? So they thought what? They would like to dismiss that agreement. Whatever the long term contract, they would like to dismiss that contract. And for that reason, they asked peasants, farmers, demanded for what? Compensation. Because landlords told that if you would like to have your land back, then you have to give your compensation, and we are dismissing your this contract. Okay, now no need to grow indigo on the land, but for that you have to give us compensation. Means, see over here, Germany had stopped what? They did not want to buy the indigo. So already the contract was what, you can say dismissed. Your contract tha, wo apne aap hi khatam ho gaya tha. Okay, destroyed. But Britishers were using their mind, and they were asking for the compensation from the farmers. Ki, we will allow you not to grow indigo. So indigo mat cultivate karo. But for that you have to give the compensation to us. So farmers were what? Already crushed, and some of the farmers wanted their land back. Some of them were excited because they wanted to get released from the indigo cultivation. So that's why some of the farmers agreed. They gave compensation, but the farmer, those who had not have the money, farmers who did not have the money, from where would they give the compensation? So they did not give the compensation. At that time Britishers did not allow them to do any cultivation without compensation. Bina compensation ke, none of the farmer was allowed to do agriculture on their land. So it was the problem. And for that, lawyers were handling their cases. So come to the point. Presently, the landlords learned that Germany had developed synthetic indigo. They thereupon obtained agreements from the sharecroppers to pay them compensation for being released from the 15% arrangement. Means they wanted 15% arrangement. If you would like to get freedom from the 15% arrangement, then you have to give us the compensation. The sharecropping arrangement was irksome. What is irksome? Troublesome. Pareshan wala tha to the peasants, and many signed willingly, and peasants signed willingly because they wanted their land back. They wanted their land back to do the cultivation. Zamine abhi bhi unko nahi mile, but unko cultivation ka, agriculture ka permission kab hoga? When they would give the compensation. Those who had done the protest against lawyers, we call the lawyers, means those who did not want to give the compensation, they hired lawyers. They wanted to fight against the system, and without compensation they wanted the right to do the cultivation or agriculture. The landlord hired thugs. Means landlord did not allow, without compensation they did not allow any of the farmer to do the agriculture on land. Meanwhile, the information about synthetic indigo reached the illiterate peasants. Means jinhone compensation de diya, they had come to know what? He already the agreement and the long term contract was dismissed. So why had they taken the compensation from us? Means it was not Britishers. Ye Britishers ka plan nahi tha. Humko indigo se kya karna, free karna. It was what? In Germany, synthetic indigo was developed, and that's why Britishers did not want indigo from us, and that's why they had released us. So they wanted their compensation back. To jinhone compensation de diya, they wanted their compensation. So here we have the two kind of the two kinds of the farmers. First, those who had not given the compensation, they wanted the land to do cultivation and agriculture. And the second category, those who had given the compensation, they wanted their compensation back. So have you understand that? So it was a system in Champaran, Bihar. At that time, Mahatma Gandhi had gone through all the things, and they wanted their money back. Unko pata pad gaya Mahatma Gandhi ko. At this point, Gandhi arrived in Champaran. After having the view of Champaran and problem of indigo sharecropper, he reached Champaran. He began by trying to get the facts. First, he visited the secretary of the British Landlords Association. So, first of all, what did Mahatma Gandhi do? Mahatma Gandhi, sabse pehla kaam after reaching Champaran, what did he do? उन्होंने क्या किया सबसे पहला काम? He approached British Landlord Association. After reaching Champaran, he approached what? After reaching Champaran, he approached Landlord Association. Visited the secretary of the British Landlord Association. Landlords Association. So it was the problem that he reached Champaran, and first of all, his first task was what in Champaran? What did he do? He visited the secretary of the British Landlord Association. British Landlord Association, where all the data of peasants were placed. So he wanted to take those files and he wanted to do the study of the peasants. what they had given to the Britishers. He wanted to know, so he approached. But what did secretary say? He began by trying to get the facts. First he visited the secretary of the British Landlord Association. The secretary told him that they could give no information to an outsider. Hum aapko information nahi denge because you are an outsider. Gandhi answered that he was no outsider. Gandhi told that he was no outsider. He belonged to India and I have the right to know the information. Mere paas mein rights hai, main outsider nahi hu. Next, Gandhi called on British Official Commission. So the secretary complained to British Official Commission. चंपारण की जो ये लैंडलॉर्ड एसोसिएशन की जो सेक्रेटरी थे उन्होंने आगे कंप्लेन कर दी कि गांधी केम एंड वाज आस्किंग फॉर द डिटेल्स एंड ऑल. सो नेक्स्ट गांधी कॉल्ड ऑन द ब्रिटिश ऑफिशियल कमिश्नर ऑफ द त्रिहत डिवीजन इन विच द चंपारण डिस्ट्रिक्ट ले. सो त्रिहत डिवीजन मीन्स सपोज इन केस सीकर इज इन जो आता है वी हैव यू कैन से Rajasthan is distributed in how many you can say parts 7. Okay, so we are in Jaipur part. Aisa hai Sikar. So same way Champaran was in Trihat division. Okay, we are in Jaipur division. We have 7 divisions right now. We have 7 divisions in Rajasthan. Okay, and we are in Jaipur division. So Trihat division. Champaran was in Trihat division at that time. So officer. British official commissioner of that area of Trihat division, he called Gandhi. Okay, Trihat division in which Champaran district lay. Commissioner Gandhi ne kaha. Gandhi told in interview. Commissioner, jo commissioner tha, proceeded to bully me. He bullied me. He wanted to make a fear in me. मुझे डराने की कोशिश की. Bully me. Okay, and advised me forthwith to leave Trihat, and he ordered Mahatma Gandhi to leave Trihat. He asked him to leave Trihat. Okay, Gandhi did not leave. Gandhi nahi gaya. From Champaran, instead he proceeded to Motihari. Then he went to Motihari, nearby village, the capital of Champaran. Okay, several lawyers accompanied him. बहुत सारे lawyers भी वहाँ गए उनके साथ में. At the railway station, a vast multitude greeted Gandhi. Why? Because they were excited. They thought that now their problem could be solved. क्योंकि कौन आ गया है? Gandhi. And there was, you can say, air of Gandhi. Gandhi की पूरी air थी. Why? Because he had solved many cases in South Africa. So it was in news. He went to a house. एक वो घर में गए. And using it as a headquarter. He stayed in a house over there and he used that house as a headquarter and he called the peasants of Motihari to collect more information against the system. Continued his investigation. A report came that in that a prison had been maltreated in nearby village. So Gandhi was informed when he was in Motihari that a peasant in nearby village was brutally beaten. So mara ja raha hai. He wanted his land back to do agriculture, but Britishers were not angry. So Gandhi thought to meet that peasant. Okay, Gandhi ne socha us peasant se mila jaye. So Gandhi decided to go and see the next morning. He started out on the back of an elephant. And Mahatma Gandhi started his journey towards that area to meet that peasant. He had not proceeded. He had not moved far when the police superintendent's messenger, messenger, his messenger overtook him and ordered him. Means he stopped Mahatma Gandhi and ordered him to return to town. You should not proceed ahead. आप लौट जाइए. Means from Motihari, go back. चले जाइए. You are not allowed to move ahead. In his carriage, Gandhi complied over there. Means what if Gandhi was equipped on that time, the messenger brought Gandhi home where he served him with an official notice to quit Champaran immediately. Gandhi then reached to his office, the house which he used as office, and over there messenger had given him a slip, an order दिया. What was written in that order? To quit Champaran immediately. क्या आप चंपारण छोड़ के चले जाइए. Means you should leave Champaran. Gandhi signed a receipt. Gandhi signed a receipt because Gandhi was a follower of principle. He was a man of the principles, and that's why he signed the receipt. He told that yes, I had received the order. मुझे the order मिल गया. But what did he say? लेकिन उसने कहा क्या? You should note it and you should underline it. What? Gandhi signed a receipt for the notice and wrote on it that he would disobey the order. That he would not. Obey the order means Gandhi signed kiya, but he told that he would not obey the order of the police superintendent, and that created the new scenario because up to refuse a police superintendent means to go for a jail or to call in a court. अब देखते हैं वहां पे क्या होता है फिर. इन कॉन्सिक्वेंस एज अ रिजल्ट गांधी रिसीव्ड द समन्स टू अपीयर इन कोर्ट द नेक्स्ट डे. एज अ रिजल्ट व्हेन पुलिस सुपरिटेंडेंट केम टू नो दैट गांधी रिफ्यूज्ड हिम गांधी डिसओबेड हिम देन ही फाइल्ड अ केस अगेंस्ट गांधी एंड गांधी वाज कॉल्ड इन द कोर्ट. ओके नाउ वी विल सी इन द कोर्ट व्हाट विल हैपन. ओके एंड हाउ did Mahatma Gandhi resolve the case of Champaran Indigo share croppers. Thank you. Have a nice day.